हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ मुस्कान। आई एम अ लीगल इन द नेटफ्लिक्स लिकेन कंपनी। सो द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज मोहिंद्र सिंह वशिष्ठ। सो लेट्स प्रोसीड विद आवर टॉपिक। मैटेरियल फैक्ट्स। इन जनवरी 1949 दलीप सिंह वाज मर्डर्ड। द डिसीज वाज द ब्रदर ऑफ बजीतर सिंह एंड जीता सिंह। बजीतर सिंह हैज लॉज्ड अ कंप्लेंट अगेंस्ट 17 पर्संस इंक्लूडिंग द एपीलेंट मोहिंद्र सिंह फॉर रॉन्गफुली कटिंग अ ट्री दैट वाज इन हिज पोजेशन। A date was fixed for hearing the said matter on 28 February 1949 before the NAP Tehsildar. On the date of hearing, the deceased and Jita Singh were attacked by the appellant and the 70-year-old boy Gumnam Singh. Both the brothers were returning from their fields when they were attacked. The deceased had a cutlass in his hand and his brother was carrying a load of fodder on his head. The first attack was directed towards Jita Singh. The appellant fired the bullet which hit Jita Singh and instantly fell. The deceased was being chased by Gumnam Singh around the outer boundary of the tank that was close by from the opposite side. The appellant caught him and shot him in the chest. Gumnam Singh also reached the spot and fired from a distance of about 4 to 5 feet near the deceased ears. The deceased died on the spot. Jita Singh went to the police station and filed the first information report against the appellant and Gumnam Singh for murdering his brother. They were charged with section 302 and 307, read with section 34 of the IPC. Arguments on behalf of prosecution. The prosecution has not examined any person from the locality in supporting their argument. The entire case rests on the evidence produced by three witnesses, that is Jita Singh, Hanam Singh and Bhuta Singh. Jita Singh asserts that he has seen the co-accused shooting his brother at the time of incident. Hanam Singh was coming from another village to fetch medicine for his maternal cousin when he saw the incident. Bhuta Singh had come to see Hanam Singh an evening before the incident took place. The Z was present near the crime scene. The prosecution had produced three other witnesses to prove their claim against the appellant. Arguments on behalf of defense. The defense has produced observation made by Dr. Joe Goyle, director of CID laboratory, Florida, or the empty cartridges. It was submitted that the guns had signs of being fired, but he could not tell the exact time when they were fired last. There is ambiguity over the fact that whether cartridges were fired from P-16 or another similar gun. The appellant had denied the allegation of firing at the deceased and Jita Singh. At the time of the incident, he had gone to the NAP Tehsildar Court, Session Court and High Court. The police filed the charge sheet against the said accused after the investigation was incomplete. The matter was then heard by Session Judge of Firozpur. The judge convicted the appellant under Section 302 and the co-accused was sentenced to transportation of life. Both of them were also sentenced to 3 years degrees imprisonment. The post-mortem reports indicate that the deceased had succumbed to gunshot injuries. There were total 6 injuries on his body. Jita Singh had suffered mortal injury on his back and from the pellets and blunt weapons. When the investigating officer reached the crime scene, he found an empty cartridge case at the place where Jita Singh was attacked and 2 empty cartridge cases and the blood-stained cartridge where the deceased body was lying. The police questioned the appellant whether he possessed any gun. He had a licensed 12-bore gun. The entire incident took place in the area surrounding the Gurdwara and local houses. Both the Session Court and High Court have held the appellant alibi to be unsatisfactory and he had been convicted of the said charges. So, that's all for today. If you like my video, do like, comment and subscribe the Lex Click YouTube channel. Thank you.